from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Patriots going up against the Falcons. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Larry, they broke ground on this place in the year 2000, opened it in August of 2002, and it's been the home of this franchise ever since. Welcome to NRG Stadium in Houston. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here between the New England Patriots and the Atlanta Falcons. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used, honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope that they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan. Hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
They run. Devontae Freeman. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one. All right, let's look at the offense. Devontae Freeman, this is a guy that you wanted to talk about, so take it away.
Brandon, have you seen a running back play with such joy as well as such fury? I love the way he runs the football and attacks defenses.
On third and one, Ryan. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of just a couple there, but it's enough to get him the first.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. Now a play fake here on first down. And this one complete to Levine Toilolo. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and five. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On second down, Freeman. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them. Pulled, nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
Now it's Ryan. And that's caught by Tammy. 9 yards on the play and a first down.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even add it a little extra at the end with a short run.
Hey, Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
So one quarter down here in Super Bowl 51. 0-0 our score. We'll return after this message. You're watching the NFL, and it's right here on EA Sports. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Again, they'll run with Freeman. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Ryan now to throw on third down. And this is caught at the end. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
I'd love to sit down at some point in our offseason and talk to these defensive coordinators in the red zone. Tight end is obviously a big threat. Yet these guys continue to make plays. Is there any other way to stop them?
Apparently not. In the red zone, like you said, that's your guy. They got it to him.
Supreme confidence in going to a playmaker. Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
Brandon, we've seen an incomplete pass and an attempted run, not getting them anywhere at all. I'm not sure they're committed on this drive about what they want to do. I just wonder if they just say, listen, let's line up and run this thing and make it 4-down territory.
Both the run and pass still in play here on third and goal from the 3. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts the defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. So that drive spans 13 plays, and it ends in a touchdown run from Devontae Freeman. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Brady now on first down. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports halftime report. Brady to throw on second down. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The former Bill, Chris Hogan, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Throwing is Brady on third down, and that is incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. And fourth down coming up. So on fourth down, the left-footed Ryan Allen to kick it away for the Pats. Back deep for the Falcons is Eric Weems. Stop it. Hits at the eight, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Freeman again. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. Third down now following the run. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Give them a lot of credit. They ended up running the ball on a key third down situation. They were staring three and out in the face and found a way to flip the script and keep the ball moving on offense.
They go play action here on first down. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
I know that's their first connection in this game, but you and I both know that Julio Jones is, without a doubt, his quarterback's favorite target.
Oh, yeah, Matt Ryan loves this guy. And who wouldn't?
Yeah, and the reason that he's that is because of his dependability. And quarterbacks have to have that from their receivers, meaning they know where they're going to be when they're running certain routes. They don't break them on them. They don't change them up and do their own freelance stuff and put their quarterbacks in bad situations. Matt Ryan has ultimate trust in Julio Jones.
And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down.
And it doesn't matter who we talk to. It doesn't matter what week in the season. At some point when we talk to the head coach or the offense coordinator or the quarterback, what are they going to talk about? Decision-making.
Yep.
Making good decisions. That throw there certainly was not one of them.
This is Freeman. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. So we've reached halftime at a low-scoring 51st Super Bowl from Houston. As we send you over to our...
Do you seriously just skip the halftime of the Super Bowl? Who does that? It's a Super Bowl. Watch the halftime show. All right, here we go.
Third quarter action now. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Now, Deion Lewis to return. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Falcons defense gearing up as they take the field. They don't want to change anything. They've got 0 points against them here, so I would imagine the halftime speech was do more of the same, right?
I think you're right, and it's where defensive coordinators have to walk that line of preparing for the adjustments you expect to come, but not taking away the aggressiveness you've already shown. And they played so well, I think that's the speech. You nailed it. Just go out and do what you've been doing, and we'll adjust if we see anything different later.
To this point, they've been spectacular.
That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, we're not able to find any yardage on that one.
Brady Gibbs now to Bunn, and he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Give him three on the play, and all of a sudden here, it's third down.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on third and 14. Here's Coleman. Ooh, with a juke. And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. Losing 4 yards that time. And now it's fourth down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
Ryan. And it is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it, predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. They slot Gronkowski outright. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that 3 and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. They'll run it here with Blunt. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Rob Gronkowski from 4 yards out. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up.
The athleticism of Rob Gronkowski sometimes mesmerizes me to where I forget he is. In days gone by, he would have been playing offensive tackle in this league.
He plays tight end like he's a wide receiver. And when you see a pass coming to him, and you know that ball's just turning, it just stops, even when one paw snatches it, as we just saw there.
It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. The drive there only spanning 3 plays, and it ends with a New England touchdown. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And the Falcons now making their way back out onto the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Ryan on second down. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. One quarter remains in Super Bowl 51. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. 7-7 is our score. Pretty even matchup so far as we start quarter number 4. They come up in an offset eye. Ryan. And Tammy with it over the middle. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
A beautiful spin and room to run. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Fresh set of downs here. Freeman again, a first down carry. Oh, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Tie game late, and the offense really has to be conscious of the clock here as it's becoming a factor late in this ball game. On first and 10, it's Ryan. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he showed a nice little juke, but then the window quickly closed. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to...
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. A little under 2 minutes to go in Super Bowl 51 from Houston. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Ryan to throw. Incomplete on the right side. It's Tammy. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
So the offense has it first and 10. They come up in an offset eye. This is Freeman on first and 10. Down to the 20. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots.
So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. Here's Ryan. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Still up. Now whistles blow, and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. And this seemingly endless drive continues. They'll run it now out of the gun. And it'll push his way up to about the 14. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Throwing now is Ryan. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. Third down here.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Here's Ryan. And he fires one, but incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And now it's fourth down. Game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. This one to the sideline. He's got it. A nice job to keep the feet in, but he is a bit short here of a first down. So they pass on the chance to kick the go-ahead field goal, and that may be one they're going to regret big time.
And I think the head coach is going to have some splaining to do, right? Because in this situation, you kick the field goal to give yourself that chance at victory. By going for it, maybe you're saying you don't trust your field goal kicker, or maybe he knows something we don't. Maybe the kicker's hurt. So there'll be a lot of questions to put. Game press conference
makes the rest of this fourth quarter and the rest of this game very interesting. To throw is Brady. He's got time. Great protection, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Well, timeout on their side here. In fact, a lot going against them. They do have a small glimmer of hope.
No one likes to play extra football. They want to go for the win right now.
Now Blunt. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. Call it a 3-yard gain, but they'll be forced to do a 3rd and 15 coming up.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level play.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And an overtime playoff game, but the rules, they stay the same as they did in the regular season.
That's exactly right. Whoever scores first, unless it's a touchdown, the other team has a chance to match. That's how it really gets played out. But remember this, no matter how far we go in overtime, in the regular season, there was only one period. Here, we're going to go until we have a winner.
Nothing between these two teams for 4 quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. Here's Eric Weems now on the return. They juked him. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense. offense now ready to take over here. This is the first Super Bowl ever to go to overtime. Can you believe you and I are on hand for this?
This is so cool to be here for the first time.
He's got daylight, the 30. And he is into the end zone. It's a touchdown. And in perhaps the greatest Super Bowl ever, they have won the game in overtime.
Wow.
And it's over. The Lombardi Trophy belongs to the Falcons. Yes, the Atlanta Falcons are the Super Bowl champions. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.